Campus's Living Lab focuses on taking the students out of the classroom and using the campus itself as a point of study. And so I started thinking about, okay, campus as a living lab. Well, what keeps the campus alive, right? If the campus, if we were to parallel it with biology, it's energy. It's energy. The interesting part is, where is that energy coming from? Today we're at the central plant, and the main purpose of the central plant is to cool and heat the school. A lot of the electrical energy consumed by the whole school is consumed here at the central plant, and that's simply to heat and cool the classrooms. So I thought, what a great point of study for the students, for them to come here and say, okay, what's behind the scenes? What's the day-to-day operation of what makes a college actually run? But not only that, where's the energy coming from? How are the rooms cooled? How are the rooms heated? What is behind that? And how much does that cost? This is a chiller. This basically chills water, and that water is used to cool the classrooms. The chillers are constantly running, so they're consuming mass amounts of kilowatt hours. And if they're running during the day, those are prime time hours, you're hitting tier 2, tier 3 Edison rates. You don't want that. So right outside, there is a very large tank called the TES tank, which is called the Thermal Energy Storage System. That tank basically saves cool water to be used for AC during the day. And then you can just pump that water without running the chillers. And you save a ton of money by doing that. This is the central plant computer. This is where everything's done in terms of setting the temperatures for whatever classroom you want on campus. It also provides us to be efficient in our use of energy. For instance, if a classroom isn't being used, we can actually turn off the AC and heating to that room. The cool part about this is that students really get to come in here and take data from here. And then later, can analyze that data. How much does it cost? How much was used per day? How much was used per month? But the students absolutely loved it. They had so many questions. I think that was, when you're actually going on the tour and you're with the students, they're like, what about that? What about that? And there's all kinds of stuff. It's a gold mine for physics in action. The future for using the central plant as a living lab is that I'd like to implement a lab for each of my physics classes. Because when I take them here, we can actually show them a lot of the ideas we studied, like energy, Bernoulli's principle, fluid flow, system efficiency. What it does is it provides an opportunity for the faculty member to communicate with their students, but outside of the classroom, and it puts them in a new environment. So not only are they learning about their subject outside of the classroom, they're also learning about their school. And the student realizes, wow, the professor actually cares. Not only that, you're getting a transparent idea of what is going on around your environment in terms of academia.